Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Today we would be driving this, that is, sorry the key fail. This is the Hyundai Elite I20 2019 model. This is the top of the line Asta optional model, and you can see here it's in silver color here. So let's straight away start with the engine bay. Let me open this, it's a bit heavy. So this is powered by, this is a petrol engine. This is a four cylinder VTVT petrol engine. This engine produces around 83 PS and 140 Nm of torque. And this engine has been carried away by the previous generations also, the Hyundai Elite I20. And this has made it to a 5-speed gearbox, and now they have revised the engine, which makes the lower end performance of the engine pretty good, and there is a considerable improvement in performance by the latest engine update. So let me close this. So talking about the design language of this car, this has been the latest and by far the best design according to many people and a lot of magazines like Autocar and something. And as the signature elements like big Hyundai logo here, this gasket design which is common in all Hyundai cars now, and overall if we go about the theme of the car, it looks pretty good, pretty nice. So starting about this, in the top end variant, that is Asta optional, you get this headlights, that is the projector setup, and you get a conning light. This projector is basically a bi-beam projector, that means the low beam and high beam are both integrated into the same unit. Here you get the fog lamp, there is a functional air damp too. The air passes here and reduces the turbulence near the wheels, which in turn reduces the vibrations and hence improves the stability of the car. So let's move here. Now here you can see in the top line variant, you can see the design of the alloys are really good, and you get this design in only the top end variant. And here you can see the tire size is 195 55 R18. 195 section is pretty good for this size, and the 16 inch alloys are only available in the top end variant. In the lower variant, 15 inch and 14 inch respectively. So moving along the side, you can see there's a side body cladding. You get chrome door handles with the request sensor. ORVMs integrated are, the indicators are integrated into the ORVMs. These are electrically foldable and adjustable. You can see the space is really nice. Now here is where you can find, at the back side only, you can find the real change in the Elite I20. They have completely changed the design from the last generation, and you can see these are chunky lights here, this kind of treatment which makes it a sort of a SUV type look, and the bumper is also in finish in dual tone now. Here you get the lights, you get reflectors here, the reverse light is placed here, you get reverse sensors, reverse camera is placed right here, I20 badging, Asta badging, and you get also this reverse wiper and the top end variant, and you also get a spray from here. This is the high mounted stop lamp and an antenna. So let's start with opening the boot. It's an electromagnetic tail opener, you just need to press a button and the boot opens. Please excuse me for this. I'll just keep this to a side. Now here, as you can see, it is a pretty generous boot. It's 285 liters, the boot space, and the spare wheel that you get is not an alloy. It's a space saver. Yeah, it's a space saver. You can see 185, 65, R15. This is a steel rim in interest of cost cutting. And let me close this. And you can actually, I just forgot to show you this, you also get this emergency exit, and you can also open the boot just by bringing the key close and the boot unlocks. So let's move to the back seat. As you can see, the bench has been increased. There's a considerable more width and more space in this. So let me sit here first. Now as you can see, the front seat has been set for my position, and I'm 6'3", I'm quite tall, and you can see there is still considerable amount of headroom and legroom here. I can easily fit here, so kudos to So I can easily sit here. So you can see the space has been improved from the considerably. The space has been improved from the last generation. I can easily sit here, and the bench is wide enough. I think two people would be at most comfort, but if three people given a chance, they can sit easily. You also get an AC vents here. You can change the direction of the blower for the two people here. And you also get a central armrest here with two cup holders, which makes the sitting experience much more better. And here you get adjustable headrests. There's a parcel tray. This is an add-on. This is not... this is aftermarket thing. You get handles with both handles get hanging. This coke hanging. You get a central light placement here. Two speakers and two tweeters in the top-end variant. You also get ISOFIX child seat mounts and seat belts for all the three passengers. So let's move to the forward seat. So now, as you can see, the door opens quite wide, and you here get the controls for folding the ORVM. This is to adjust the ORVM left, right by this. This is the power window controls. Driver side is up and down, auto up and down, and you also get a pinch guard. And here the seating. The seat, you can recline the seat, you can raise the height, and you can move it forward and back, pretty similar to every car's. You also get a dead pedal there, and this is to open the fuse box, and this is to open the boot, and here you get the full fuel lid opening lid. The fuel tank capacity comes down to be 40 liters in this car. So let me sit in the car. So let us turn on the car first. You get a push button start in the Asta optional variant. So the design language is being same from the last generation. You get a pretty well-built cabin, and here you can see you get all your controls at the 8-inch touchscreen. This also has integrated maps, that is offline maps, which do not need internet to work, and all the basic functions, Android Auto, Apple CarPlay and all. Here, moving to here, you get the sunglass holder, you get two lights here, you get vanity mirror here. You don't get a vanity mirror here. And moving to the safety features of the car, you get six airbags. Two airbags are standard from right from the base variant. You get six airbags in this car. And you get ABS, you get EBD, auto door unlock, speed sensitive door locks, also impact sensing automatic door unlock. There are a lot of features except of these. Let me just turn on the car first. You just need to press this button. This gets push button start. You do not need to do anything else. Here you get the button to lock on unlock the doors. This is the hazard light switch. Here you get the automatic AC. This is the blow control, this is the temperature control, and all the automatic. Latestly, they have introduced this, that is the wireless charger, in which you can directly place your phone here and it starts charging. You get USB chargers, that is one and two. This USB is used for your entertainment purposes, and this is the aux. Here you get two cup holders, different sized. You get an armrest here. This armrest is also sliding, handbraked, a 5-speed gearbox in petrol variant, and a 6-speed gearbox in the diesel. So basically, the I20 is offered in both engines, diesel and petrol. Petrol, as I've already told, it's 1.2 liters VTVT petrol engine and 1.4 U2 CIDI diesel engine. And you get both the options of a manual and a CVT in both the petrol and the diesel variant. You also get the height adjustable steering belts, that is pretty nice. The overall, the quality and the fit and finish of the cabin is really nice. Not very hard plastics. They give a solid thud, and they give a sort of premium feel in the cabin. You also get tweeters here. These are chrome plated door handles. And the steering wheel is also really nice. Here you get the audio control, that is to lower or increase the volume. Here is to skip to the next track, mute mode to pick up or end calls, and you can also give voice commands here. This is used to browse the MID. As you can see, it's accumulated info. It also digital speed. This is the average and many more. You can set also a lot of things here. There are a lot of things that could be set here. This is the RPM meter, and this is the speedometer. You also get all the HR lights all over, and this is the distance to empty. The air conditioning in this car really works well. It is pretty good, and the ORVM is manually dimmable. You can just press this to dim, and no automatic dimming present here. On the left side, you get the wiper stalk. The wipers work pretty well, as you can see. This is the stalk for the indicators and the headlamp. So talking about the infotainment screen, you get the Archimedes sound system, and this sound system is really nice. If I will just play something for you. As you saw, the audio quality is really nice. It's among the best in the segment, and you get also a lot of features except from this screen mirroring and all are basic, all common in this. So overall, the car is really good. I think it's the best in the segment. That's why it's able to sell more than 15,000 units per month. That is a huge number. The immediate rivals to this car could be Maruti Baleno, and Honda Jazz is also considered a sort of competition to this vehicle. So let's start driving. So talking about the engine, it feels really good to drive. The suspension setup is also improved in this car. You get Mech Pearson struts and coupled torsion beam axle with gas type shock absorbers in the front and rear, which is really good. They absorb any type of potholes and bumps really well. There is no sound of suspension working inside the cabin, and the cabin is really silent. Being a petrol engine, it hardly you can barely hear the engine inside the cabin. And talking about the performance of this engine, this is the petrol. I've already spoken about this. It produces around 83 bhp and a 140 nm of torque. And what Hyundai has done here is that they have really worked upon the lower end of this engine, and hence they have made it really well. Earlier, the I20 used to struggle, especially the petrol variant used to struggle in the lower RPMs, but now this problem has been resolved and it feels sort of punchy low down. I20 has been criticized a lot about its pickup and less fuel average, but thanks to Hyundai, they have worked really well this time. Let me just take a U-turn here. So talking about the average, this average is reduced. 12.7 is not the right average. It would be because the car was standing for a lot of time. This engine could return you around 13.5 to 14 kilometers in city, depending on your driving style, obviously. And it could stretch up to 21 and even 22 on highway. The gearbox feels really nice, typical to Hyundai cars. It works flawlessly. You can feel the gear shifts, and there's nothing to complain as such. So overall, talking about the car, it's really nice, and especially considered the price, it's slight premium over its competition, but I feel this car is completely worth the extra price that you pay for this, because you get a premium product for this and you get a satisfaction that is not matched by any other car in this segment. So I hope you like this video. And if you liked it, please share, please subscribe and like this video, and do let me know your thoughts and a car if you want me to review in the future. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.